Okay, if you've seen this meme before, I'm sure that's how a lot of us have felt the past year when, or the past few years really, technology is continuing to change at such a quick pace. It's hard, if not impossible, to keep up with it. Alongside that though, I often find that myself and others, I'm including myself in there too, because I think we all do this to some degree, when this new technology, or maybe it's not new, but it starts getting hype. We went from Web3 being super popular and, you know, getting paid these crazy salaries to now everyone's switching into AI and that's where to be. It can be overwhelming. Do I go in that area? Do I focus on that direction? Is it going to just be, is it actually going to stay a trend or is it just a hype? There's a lot of questions and a lot of things to unpack here. And it also brings up the question, am I going to become irrelevant? In this video, I'm going to share with you different insights and advice backed up by data that I have around the big question, which is, how to stay relevant in the tech industry. This question is more important than ever as tech continues to grow at a faster pace. How do we stay relevant? How do we stay in demand? Where should we put our focus and our learnings? If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos, and let's get into it. Speaking of staying relevant and keeping up to date with all these tech trends, I wanted to share with you one of the tools that I've been using for my email automation, collaboration, and getting statistics behind it, Mailjet. Mailjet is an easy to use marketing platform for designing, sending, and monitoring email marketing campaigns, also including newsletters and automated emails. So whether you are a solo entrepreneur or you lead a collaborative team, Mailjet has a drag and drop email editor that helps you create beautiful emails that connect with new and existing customers. I know for me, the drag and drop editor has been a huge game changer. I don't have to go in and code anything. It's very easy to use. And to kind of expand on that point, you can create and send beautiful emails without having to touch a single line of code. So the email editor makes it easy to create engaging email campaigns, newsletters, and also automated emails in literally minutes. Also too, they have a ton of different pre-designed templates, so you can focus more time on different tasks versus the design of the templates. What should I use? For me, that has really helped. And you know I love numbers, so they also have statistics. You can actually get actionable insights to create engaging campaigns. So you can track the performance of your email marketing campaigns in real time, see what works, what doesn't work, and learn from that. Two other things I want to highlight, one being segmentation. So you can send customized emails to your customers that they actually want to open. So with Mailjet's segmentation feature, you can send specific and targeted messages based on each customer's interests, attributes, and behaviors. So you don't have to send a blanket email versus you can actually send customized emails to different segmentations. And also to automation, you know, anything automate that I can automate, I am here for. So you can streamline your email workflow so you can engage with new and existing customers at the right moment with the right message. So maybe you are like me and you're managing your own business while working at a company. You can't be doing both at the same time. So this is a huge feature to automate emails so they can arrive at the inboxes when you actually want them to. Thank you again to Mailjet for sponsoring this video. I love you. And I also linked Mailjet down below so you can try them out for free today. And when it comes to developing your technical skill set, we often think about our technical skills, which makes sense. The problem is a lot of times we put too much focus on just the technical aspect, what we should be learning next, where the trends are going, what technology is going to be in demand. And in turn, we forget about the importance of our soft skills. Developing soft skills such as communication, collaboration, negotiation, leadership. These are all skills that will help you work better in teams. And at the end of the day, I really truly believe that yes, technical skills are so important, especially if you're obviously in a technical role, but regardless of that, it's important to not neglect the soft skills.
All right, we're heading to my co-working space. I need to get out of the house today. I'm feeling a little housebound. But at the end of the day, people hire people. And I know some of us, or sometimes we go, why do I have to focus on soft skills? I got in tech so I could focus on technical skills. Or maybe you're someone who's very focused on soft skills and you're thinking, why do I need to learn or understand the basics even of technical skills? We all have our strengths and our weaknesses. And the reality is though, people hire people. I can't emphasize that enough. It's so important because it might not seem fair, it might not seem right, but a lot of people would rather work with good people who can learn technical skills than people who have these great technical skills but not the ability to communicate, to collaborate.
Now, let's get a little bit into the data, into the numbers. Well, for one thing, according to Forbes, the demand for cloud computing engineers will increase by at least 26% by 2023, this year today. And the jobs for artificial intelligence could grow by 28% this year. Those are big numbers. Now, why am I sharing them with you? What relevance does it have to do? It's kind of random, Tiff. Well, the relevance is this. I could continue to go on in this list for different roles in tech that are continuing to go in demand and increase. So, why am I sharing these with you? Because I want to put your mind at ease that you don't need to necessarily chase the latest and greatest technology in order to be in demand. I just listed two completely different areas that are continuing to grow in demand. And I mean, we could go on. Let's see here, what else do we have? Roles related to big data analytics may increase by 39%, stated by Forbes again. Continuing to grow and grow. So there are so many options, and the last thing I want you to do is, as you are seeing, especially right now with AI or with Web3, as you're seeing these things become so hyped, and a lot of times for good reason, I'm not saying there isn't reasoning behind them, but don't just keep on pivoting from one to the other, rather stay focused on your path. Now, for example, let's give a good example as to how you can continue to stay in demand. Say you are a web developer. I'm just using this as an example, but this could be related to really marketing, to any kind of skills you have. You're focused on your path. Well, the best way to kind of continue to be in demand, other than networking and building those soft skills and relationships, is just get curious. Now, what do I mean by this?
All right, we are off. Even based on those stats and numbers I just shared with you, it should be even more reason to realize that maybe the best way to stay relevant and stay in demand, your job, your career in demand, is to do the opposite of what everyone else is doing. So what do I mean by that? The more I think about it and the more I strategically think about my career, I realize that rather than just going with the trends and focusing on what everyone else is doing, the problem with that is you're never going to actually become an expert in any area. You're going to try out this trend and then you're quickly going to realize there's a new trend coming around, you know, Web3, AI, whatever is next, and you're never going to actually become an expert in the things that you're learning. There's no problem with being a generalist, but if you're a generalist, you need to be able to pick up new things very quickly, and that's the purpose. You're purposefully a generalist. If you are just picking up new things because you want a higher salary, it's not going to work, or at least in the long term anyways. One of the best things that I really like to do, and it's really helped me thus far in my career, is being open to evolving and growing and being really open to new technologies, but having a short-term or medium-term plan. So meaning the next 5 years, what does that look like for you? Are you staying at the same company you're at? And obviously this can change as you grow and your experiences change, but having a rough timeline, and then as these new technologies come up, it's less tempting to be like, I need to enter into companies around AI, or I need to enter into companies around X, Y, and Z, whatever it is. But staying focused on your plan, because in turn, it will give you time, first of all, to see how these trends pan out. The other thing it will do too is position yourself as an expert. Position yourself as an expert in whatever role you are in, industry you're in tech or sub-industry, what would you call it? Niche industry? I don't know. And it will just give you more credibility. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna film the rest of this video in my car. I feel like we're intimate. We got a good vibe going on. Let's just like wrap it up in this way. One thing I wanted to touch on though is there's no right or wrong way to stay relevant, and that's why I'm not providing a specific prescription, you could say, like if you do this and then you do that, you will stay relevant. But it's more so about your mindset, and I hope that really came through this video. Is it's less about, okay, checking off these boxes, I did this step, now I will be in demand, and your mindset of, first of all, taking a step back and looking at the bigger picture of all these trends coming up. Second of all, yes, following the data, following the numbers. I shared some stats around cloud, around data analysts. There's so much more out there as to where the trends have been consistent for a long time and where the demand will continue to go. But it doesn't mean you need to today pick up a cloud computing course or pick up a data analyst course if you're not interested in it. You know, stay focused into what you are interested in, what you are working on, and then maybe pick up some learnings as you go. Maybe it be 10 minutes a day, maybe 10 minutes a week, and find out what that thing is that you are really passionate about and grow in that direction. I think that's really important to note. Otherwise, you're always going to be chasing the latest and greatest trend, and in turn, just get nowhere. What is that saying? A dog chasing its tail, I think it is. I don't know, you might correct me on that. I hope you really found this video helpful. I just wanted to share my thoughts around it, and because I got really sucked into
when these trends come up of focusing on, okay, now I need to learn how to code, like to be a blockchain builder. Now I need to learn how to be AI specialist. AI I'm really interested in though, not just because of the trend, but just I have been for a while. But regardless, find out what you're passionate about, focus, tune out the rest of the noise. And also too, gotta touch on it again, remember to network and also use your soft skills. Just be a good person, be a good team player. Don't just rely on your technical skills. All right, everyone, I need to go get some work done. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video covering all the ways to really stay relevant and in demand in the tech industry. And I think it's important to highlight there is no just one way, but it's whatever way works best for you. This looks different for everyone. And I really hope this video also puts your mind at ease that there is nothing to worry about. Continue to be a forever learner. I think I say that in like so many of my videos, but because it's so true, continue to upskill. You're going to be fine. Don't, you know, spend all your waking hours or even your late nights learning new things. It's not about that. It's about being open to technology as it comes your way, being open to learning, building those relationships, and you will get there. All right, friends, I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, and career-related topics. Leave in the comments any questions you have because I block off time throughout my days to answer every single one of your questions. So challenge me on that. Ask some questions down below. All right, I'll see you soon.